strength of your killer is. I live not too far from here, and like many locals, I'm curious about our new shark barrier. Without it, I don't think this beach would be nearly as popular, and I definitely wouldn't be swimming out this far. But what I really want to know is, does this $1 million project actually protect us against sharks? Let's take a look.
You might already be familiar with shark nets, such as the ones used at Sydney's Bondi Beach. By their very nature, nets catch everything that swims inside them. This can be a problem for delicately balanced ecosystems, where bycatch of whales, dolphins, and other marine creatures can have serious negative effects. Nets aren't tough enough to be installed close to shore, which gives an opening for sharks to get through. This happens a little more regularly than you might hope for. With these problems in mind, Western Australian inventor Craig Moss developed what is now the Eco Shark Barrier. Unlike a net, it doesn't try to catch sharks. Instead, it physically stops them getting through, just like a wall. The barrier is made of thousands of these cross-shaped pieces, which we can snap together to form a grid. This means that smaller fish and other marine creatures can pass through easily, while stopping sharks, dolphins, and other large species. Of course, that's only useful if the barrier doesn't break. The first line of defense is material selection. The barrier is made of nylon polymer, which is a material with high tensile strength as well as good toughness. Tensile strength is what means I can pull on the barrier without it breaking, while toughness is what allows it to survive rough conditions. The next line of defense is the modular nature of the barrier itself. This means that if there's a problem with one of the components, you can just pop it off and replace it. Swimming along the barrier, you can notice some yellow connectors, contrasting with the regular blue. These are the ones that have been replaced since the barrier was installed. The hardest bit is actually just finding the breaks in the first place. Because of this, you'll often find the inventor Craig out on his boat, monitoring the line. The properties of nylon used in this barrier ensure that it can perform its function well. Good rigidity ensures that it doesn't capture marine life, while excellent toughness means that it can be connected all the way up to the beach.
Our barrier needs to extend from seabed to surface. In order to stop sharks from swimming over, we have these air-filled floats. Down below, we have 60 anchors and about 100 tons of other weights, which ensure that the bottom stays on the seafloor, stopping sharks from swimming under.
To date, there has been no bycatch from the system, but what about other effects on marine life? Swimming along the barrier, it's easy to see that it's turning into its own ecosystem. Sea lettuce and sargassum weed grow along its surface, turning the net into a weird mash of natural and synthetic. The fish also seem to enjoy it. On the morning we filmed, I spotted herring, blue boxfish, tarwine, and batfish. In fact, there is so much life here, the marine rehabilitation centres are looking into using a similar system for marine conservation. Talking with some regular beachgoers, they did raise an issue. The jellyfish and seaweed seem to be getting caught on the swimming side of the barrier. Since the floats to the top are designed to be removable, it might be possible to lower the barrier every month or so in order to ensure that this build-up can flow out to sea. If you're interested in snorkeling, I'd recommend swimming along the barrier and further out. Further out, the water is more clear and sea life much more interesting. Massive thank you to Craig for letting us borrow some of the samples from his barrier and to the city of Joondalup for allowing us to film here. Of course, if you want to swim anywhere that isn't directly behind this barrier, then you're going to need your own personal shark deterrent. I've just written an article for the Pelican magazine discussing the science behind different shark mitigation technologies. If you're interested, go check it out. New episodes of Perth Science are landing every month, so make sure to subscribe to the channel so as not to miss them. Until next time, this has been James Dingley from the Atomic Frontier. Keep looking up.